read your Bible this morning, if you would, to the Gospel of Matthew. I told you, you know, I just felt that there's so much in the Gospel, particularly in and around the birth of Jesus, that I needed to talk about in a way that probably I've never done at Christmas. I do a couple of Christmas messages around that period, but I think I've been a bit more, into it this Christmas, and it's good to be. And maybe this will be my last message on Christmas. Amen. So that's Matthew chapter 2, it's probably projected up there in verse 11 is where I want to go to. Okay, so this story is coming from the Magi. Remember, the Magi, the wise men who had traveled all the way from the east, to come to Jerusalem to see the new thing that was happening. They said they had seen the star. These were probably stargazers. These things were very rampant in those days. We still have those. I don't know if you've ever read your star, something called your star. Come on, you've been foolish enough to read it once or twice. Everybody has been foolish enough to do that, yeah? No? Holy Mother Akan says she's never read it. Thank God for you. You know, but how many of you, you've read it? But they probably didn't have star, She didn't hear me. Okay. Hallelujah. But yes, people who claim to know what you're meant to be doing each day, and they read the star, and if you're precarious or you're Vigo or you're accessory, or I don't know. I'm just giving names. They give some really ridiculous names. What? Isaiah. I never saw Isaiah amongst those names. Can you imagine if you're cancer? These days, I don't think all those who are classified to be under cancer ever read that. You know? Huh?
Sagittarius.
Okay, thank you very much. Can we not become stargazers here? Amen and amen. And then, people believe it, and they go and look at it. So these men, anyway, were people like that. I think they were more than that. I think they were seen as sages in those times, in those seasons, who really believed what they did. How? Well, they saw the star, and they seem to be correct at this point in time. Amen? They were not believers. They were not Christians. But they followed whatever they saw, which is the star, they said. I'm not even surprised that God would even go and show them. Amen? Sometimes we just think that as Christians, God only deals with us. Very much like the Jews. The Jews thought they were the only ones who were God's people. So, God only blessed the Jews. God only revealed himself to the Jews. God never did anything with the rest of the world. And how untrue that was. And even though we have our Bible and we've read that God loves the world, we still think he only loves us Christians. And we barely ache when he blesses somebody else with some nice Lamborghini. I bet he's going to hell. Well, have you seen how Christians really barely ache when unbelievers prosper? Amen? And God prospers some of them because some of them will do a whole lot more good than you would if he prospered you. Something to think about. So this... These Magi, these wise men, let me just read it a little, because sometimes maybe some people have never read it in their Bible. It says in chapter 2 and verse 1, it says, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea, during the time of King Herod, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? We saw his star in the east and have come to worship him." Amen. Here they were, people we classify as non-believers. Yet they saw the star and they responded. They have come to worship him. How many believers actually worship God daily in their lives? When King Herod heard this, he was disturbed. And all Jerusalem with him. You've got to understand, all Jerusalem with him would be his men. Yes? Do you understand that? So when he says all Jerusalem, you know, the rest don't matter. The palace is what is described here. And when he had called together all the people's chief priests and teachers of the law. So he didn't just call his own men in the palace. He called for the teachers of the law in the community. The Sanhedrin, possibly. And he asked them where the Christ was to be born. He called the theologians, the heads of the theological seminaries, if they had some. In Bethlehem, in Judea, they replied, these people, they know their stuff. For this is what the prophet has written. But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For out of you will come a ruler who will be the shepherd of my people Israel. Then Herod called the Magi secretly and found out from them the exact time the star had appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and make a careful search for the child. As soon as you find him, report to me so that I too may go and worship him." So here are these men who have come truthfully to worship the newborn king. And here is Herod, who is fearful for his own throne, who is claiming he wants to go and worship this new king, but he had an ulterior motive. After they had heard the king, they went on their way, and the star they had seen in the east went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. And when they saw the star, they were overjoyed. On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold and of incense and of myrrh. And having been warned in a dream, having been warned, this is my text now, I just gave you a background reading from verse 1. And having been warned in a dream not to go back to Herod, they returned to their country another way. Verse 13. When they had gone, an angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream. Remember, we just read that the Magi had been warned in a dream. Now, after their visit, an angel appears to Joseph in his dream. "Get up," he said. "Take the child and his mother and escape to Egypt. Stay there until I tell you, for Herod is going to search for the child to kill him."